So it's Italy who advanced to the knockout stages, having not conceded a single goal in the group stage. Ain't that something? I knew that they were going to make a big statement, especially when you consider the fact that this Italian team missed out on the World Cup in 2018. You know they had to bounce back, at least at the Euros. But man, I don't remember Italy ever playing this strong or having this good of a start. I mean, they've always been a type of team that starts slow and then builds up progressively in the tournament, which is kind of different to see. But like, man, they don't look like they're losing any steam anytime soon. I mean, they rested some players in this match, so we didn't really get that full strength Italian side. A lot of players were rested going into the knockout stages. But yeah, man, this team literally looks like they're built to win. As for Wales, they definitely knocked on the door a couple times. They definitely gave Italy something to think about a few times. But honestly, once they got that red card, it was done. But their goal was mainly to just make sure they don't concede so that they get to the knockout stages on goal difference. But it worked. So in the end of the day, both teams were happy. Well, except for Ampadu. And it kind of sucks for Wales because he is a pretty decent defender. Prior to this game, he's come off the bench in every single match. So it'll be interesting to see how things pan out. As for Wales though, man, they've proven, especially today, that they are a hard team to break down. And you know what? They're going to challenge some of the big teams. I'm not saying that they're going to win anything. But right now, especially their position they're in, the fact that they finished runners-up in the group and they're going to be facing the runners-up in Group B, this puts them in a good position. They could either face either Finland, Russia, or Denmark. And to be honest, those seem pretty good. I mean, when you've got players like Gareth Bale, Aaron Ramsey, quality players who have experience and great chemistry and the team plays the way they do, they are going to be a hard team to compete for anybody in this tournament. I mean, it's going to be a tough match if they go up against Denmark, but against Finland and Russia, I definitely favor Wales to beat them. But that's my overall take. I mean, we'll see who ends up actually getting out of the group in Group B tomorrow. Then I'll have more of a stronger concrete view on what I think is going to happen. For now, let's just say congratulations to Wales. They finished second on goal differential. And now when we talk about Italy, hey man, they conceded 0 goals in the 3 matches. And now they're probably going to go to the round of 16 to face the winner of Ukraine and Austria, which if I'm being honest, I'd favor Italy to beat either of those teams. I mean, if they were to face Austria, for the most part, they already kind of had that test with Switzerland. I think they'd be able to handle a team like Austria pretty easily. As for Ukraine, I think they'll be a little bit more difficult to break down. Shevchenko's a great coach and all, but I would still favor Italy to get past them. So all in all, things are starting to look good for Italy. We'll just have to wait and see how the knockout tree pans out so that we can actually have a solid idea of whether or not they're actually going to go far or not. But for now, things are looking very good. Honestly, Italy look like the best team right now in the group stages. Do I think they're better than France and Belgium on paper? No, I do not. But of course, the game is played on the pitch. I don't think Italy have faced a solid enough team to really cement me or have me fully confident that they're going to 100% win. But I do think they're going to get at least as far as the semifinals or quarterfinals, bare minimum. Anything before the quarterfinals will just have me completely bamboozled. Personally, I think that the teams in Group F have honestly been a little bit more better conditioned and being molded, and you're starting to see the teams like that changing gears very early on, especially we saw with the German team against Portugal. We clearly saw how this team took it to a next gear against them. It's like you can see that they really benefited placing a big team early on. These are teams that you see in the semifinals. But credit to Italy for getting 3 shutouts, 3 clean sheets. Man, that's impressive regardless of what group you're in. Last time I checked, the only team that hasn't conceded any goals was Sweden, which is kind of ironic given the fact that Sweden were the team that actually knocked out Italy from even getting to the World Cup back in 2018. But this tournament is completely different. This is a completely different Italy team, and I don't even know if they're going to even face Sweden in the knockout stages, so I don't think that's even going to be a thing to worry about. But with that said, that's going to conclude the video. So in the end, Italy finished on top of the group, winning all 3 games, conceding 0 goals, followed by Wales in second, Switzerland in third, and Turkey finishing bottom of the group with 0 points. I will cover the Switzerland-Turkey game in the next video, but yeah, I guess it's fair to say that I overrated Turkey, since with my predictions for Group A, I had Italy finishing first, Switzerland second, Turkey third, and Wales to finish fourth. It feels foolish now looking back at it, but man, There was so much hype for Turkey going into this, but you know what? I'm gonna save that all for the next video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace out, guys.